The enchanting voice of this actor will forever remain in your memory and you will never confuse it with anyone. Norman Lloyd lived a happy long life and never complained about difficulties. Norman Lloyd's biography is interesting and full of unforeseen situations. We hope you have already poured yourself some coffee and are ready to listen to the next life story of the legendary man. Norman Lloyd was born Norman Perlmutter on November 8, 1914, in Jersey City, New Jersey. His family was Jewish and lived in Brooklyn, New York. His father, Max Perlmutter, was an accountant who later became a salesman and proprietor of a furniture store. His mother, Sadie Horowitz Perlmutter, was a bookkeeper and housewife. She had a good voice and a lifelong interest in the theater, and she took her young son to singing and dancing lessons. He had two sisters, Ruth and Janice. Lloyd became a child performer, appearing at vaudeville benefits and women's clubs, and was a professional by the age of 9. Lloyd graduated from high school when he was 15 and began studies at New York University, but left at the end of his sophomore year. All around me, I could see the way the depression was affecting everyone. For my family, for people in business like my father, it was a terrible time, he wrote. Lloyd's father died in 1945, at age 55. In 1932, at age 17, Lloyd auditioned and became the youngest of the apprentices under the direction of May Sarton at Eva Le Gallienne's Civic Repertory Theater in New York City. He then joined Sarton's Apprentice Theater in New Hampshire, continuing his studies with her and her associate, Eleanor Flexner. The group rehearsed a total of 10 modern European plays and performed at the New School for Social Research and in Boston. Members of the Harvard Dramatic Club saw Lloyd on stage and offered him the lead in a play directed by Joseph Lossie. He rejoined Sarton's group, for whom Lossie directed a Boston production of Gods of the Lightning. When Sarton was forced to give up her company, Lossie suggested that Lloyd audition for a production of André Aubé's Noah in 1935. It was Lloyd's first Broadway show. Through Lossie, Lloyd became involved in the social theater of the 1930s, beginning with an acting collective called the Theater of Action. In 1936, the group was preparing a production of Michael Blankfort's The Crime, directed by Elia Kazan. One of the company members was actress Peggy Craven, who became Lloyd's wife. Lossie brought Lloyd into the Federal Theater Project, which Lloyd called one of the great theaters of all time, and its living newspapers, which dramatized contemporary events. They initially prepared Ethiopia, about the Italian invasion, which was deemed too controversial and was terminated. The first completed presentation was AAA Plowed Under, followed by Injunction Granted and Power. When Orson Welles and John Houseman left the Federal Theater Project to form their own independent repertory theater company, the Mercury Theater, Lloyd was invited to become a charter member. He played a memorable role in its first stage production, Caesar, Welles's modern dress adaptation of Shakespeare's tragedy Julius Caesar, streamlined into an anti-fascist tour de force. In a scene that became the fulcrum of the show, Cinna the Poet, Lloyd dies at the hands not of a mob but of a secret police force. Lloyd called it an extraordinary scene that gripped the audience in a way that the show stopped for about 3 minutes. The audience stopped it with applause. It showed the audience what fascism was. The Mercury prepared the Shoemaker's Holiday to go into repertory with Caesar beginning in January 1938. During the December 25th performance of Caesar, when the sets, lighting and costumes for Shoemaker were ready but no previews had taken place, Welles asked the cast if they cared to present a surprise preview immediately after the show. He invited the audience to stay and watch the set changes, and the curtain rose at 1:15 a.m. Lloyd performed on the first of four releases in the Mercury Text Record Series, phonographic recordings of Shakespeare plays adapted for educators by Welles and Roger Hill. The Merchant of Venice features Lloyd in the roles of Solanio and Lancelot Gobbo. In 1938, Lloyd played the role of Johnny Appleseed in Everywhere I Roam, a play by Arnold Sundgaard that was developed by the Federal Theatre Project and staged on Broadway by Mark Connelly. In late summer 1939, Lloyd was invited to Hollywood to join Welles and other Mercury Theatre members in the first film being prepared for RKO Pictures, Heart of Darkness. Given a six-week guarantee at $500 a week, he took part in a reading for the film, which was to be presented entirely through a first-person camera. After elaborate pre-production, the project never reached production because Welles was unable to trim $50,000 from its budget, something RKO insisted upon as revenue was declining sharply in Europe by autumn 1939. Welles asked the actors to stay a few more weeks as he put together another film project, but Lloyd was ill-advised by a member of the radio company and impulsively returned to New York. In 1942, Lloyd later returned to Hollywood to play a Nazi spy in Alfred Hitchcock's Saboteur, beginning a long friendship and professional association with Hitchcock. 3 years later, he was cast by French director Jean Renoir to portray the malicious, dull-witted character Finley in The Southerner, which was the fourth film of six productions that Renoir directed in the 1940s while living in the United States. After a few more villainous screen roles, Lloyd then worked behind the camera as an assistant on Louis Milestone's Arch of Triumph. A friend of John Garfield, Lloyd performed with him in the 1951 film noir crime drama He Ran All the Way, Garfield's last film before the Hollywood blacklist ended his film career. A marginal victim of the Hollywood blacklist, Lloyd was rescued professionally by Hitchcock, who had previously used the actor in Saboteur and Spellbound. Hitchcock hired Lloyd as an associate producer and a director on his television series Alfred Hitchcock Presents in 1958. Previously, Lloyd directed the sponsored film A Word to the Wives with Marsha Hunt and Darren McGavin. He continued directing and producing episodic television throughout the 1960s and 1970s. He took an unusual role in the Night Gallery episode, A Feast of Blood, as the bearer of a cursed brooch, which he inflicts upon a hapless woman, played by Sandra Locke, who had spurned his romantic advances. In FM, Lloyd has a small but pivotal role as the owner of a Los Angeles radio station that is undergoing a mutiny of sorts, due to a battle over advertising. Lloyd's character, Carl Billings, ends up playing the white hat role and keeping the station as is, to the delight of staff and fans. In the 1980s, Lloyd played Dr. Daniel Auschlander in the television drama Saint Elsewhere over its six-season run. Originally scheduled for only 4 episodes, Lloyd became a regular for the remainder of the series. In addition to Ed Flanders and William Daniels, Saint Elsewhere included a roster of relative unknowns, including Ed Begley Jr., Denzel Washington, Stephen First, Eric Lonneville, David Morse and Howie Mandel. Lloyd's first film role in nearly a decade was in Dead Poets Society, playing Mr. Nolan, the authoritative headmaster of Welton Academy, opposite Robin Williams. Initially, Lloyd was hesitant when asked to audition, because he thought the director and producers could judge whether or not he was right for the part by watching his acting on Saint Elsewhere. Director Peter Weir was living in Australia and had not seen Saint Elsewhere. Lloyd agreed to audition for him after winning his daily tennis match. From 1998 to 2001, he played Dr. Isaac Mentner in the UPN science fiction drama 7 Days. His numerous television guest star appearances include The Joseph Cotton Show, Murder, She Wrote, The Twilight Zone, Wise Guy, Star Trek, The Next Generation, Wings, The Practice, and Civil Wars. Norman has played in various radio plays for Peggy Weber's California Artists Radio Theater and Yuri Rozovsky's Hollywood Theater of the Year. His most recent film role was in 2015 Trainwreck, which he acted in at the age of 99, although he admitted he was slightly put off by the film's raunchy content. He is the subject of the documentary Who is Norman Lloyd?, which premiered at the Sundance Film Festival on September 1, 2007. In 2010, he guest starred in an episode of ABC's Modern Family. On December 5, 2010, he presented an evening with Norman Lloyd at the Colony Theater in Burbank, California, where he spoke about his career and answered questions from the audience. Lloyd's wife of 75 years, Peggy, died on August 30, 2011, at the age of 98. The couple had 2 children, one of whom, actress Josie Lloyd, died in 2020. Lloyd began practicing his lifelong hobby of tennis at the age of 8. With the application and time I have devoted to it, I should have been a reigning world champion, he said in a 2000 interview. His opponents included Charlie Chaplin, Joseph Cotton and Spencer Tracy. Lloyd was still playing twice a week until July 2015, when he had a fall. He stopped driving in 2014 at his son's insistence. Lloyd turned 100 on November 8, 2014. On October 25, 2017, just 2 weeks shy of his 103rd birthday, Lloyd attended Game 2 of the 2017 World Series in Los Angeles. 91 years earlier, at the age of 11, he had attended Game 1 of the 1926 World Series at Yankee Stadium. Norman Lloyd died during his sleep at the age of 106 in the morning of May 11, 2021, at his home in Los Angeles.